Okay, in this video, I'm going to talk about two different house parties that I've been to. One of them was back when I was in sixth form, and it was awkward as fuck, yeah? And it was a train wreck, and I just remember little bits of it, and like the overall night, I just remember it just being just not great. And then the other one is going to be the complete opposite, and this was like a university 2 or 3 years later down the line. And everything went fucking right. Yeah, and the disparity between these two events was so extreme, but it was the same environment. It was just a house party, you know? Going there, having fun, people involved, drinking, like, music. Two exact same events, same person, went to both of them, 3 years apart. One of them, bad, just train wreck, really, just awkward. Other one, really good. I'm going to explain why there's a difference and what I did differently. Okay, so this might be useful for some of you out there. Let's go through the first one first so we can see a massive transformation. The first one, I was in sixth form, a group of friends, and you know, there were some other people at this party who weren't necessarily in this group, but they were like kind of on the outskirts of the friendship group, right? You know what I'm talking about? There were some people at the party. There was like, I'd say around 20 to 30 people. I can't remember exactly, it was a long time ago. 20 to 30 people at this party. And I was relatively new to going out and drinking with people. There was certain times, certain parties where I got invited to where I really didn't want to go. I was very awkward and shy. Anytime you do something new, you're gonna be not great at it. Yeah, that can be anything. That can be driving, that can be skateboarding, that can be going to socializing at parties. So I wasn't great at it back then, obviously. But I forced myself to go to some of these parties where I didn't want to go, which was a very fucking big step that I needed to take. I remember this party. I just remember music playing, everyone dancing, everyone like was kind of having a great time, speaking, like having fun, you know, what people do at parties. And I remember just not being fucking involved. I remember just holding my cup awkwardly, not drunk, kind of like there, just in the corner, just not really speaking to anyone, not dancing, in my fucking head about, oh, should I be dancing? Should I be speaking? Why am I not speaking to people? Why am I just standing there holding a cup? This didn't just happen once, it just happened at quite a few parties when I first started going. And I remember, like, there was guys and girls, and the guys and girls, some of them were getting together, right, and doing, you know, getting together. And it was never me. I was always the guy at the end. Do you know when a party gets to that point where everyone just goes off in their couples or pairs and does their own thing away from everyone? I was always part of the people remaining with no one to go off and do that with. I was wondering why. I was like, what's happening? What are they doing differently to what I'm doing? But looking back, I fucking understand why. Because I was just there, not fucking being involved, right? I wasn't speaking to anyone, wasn't being social at all. You go to a club, you go to a party, you go to a bar, people want to have fucking fun in these places. So if you rock up and you're in a bad mood and you're just doing nothing and you're grumpy, well, of course no one's gonna want to fucking speak to you, are they? If you're at a club and you're standing on the wall like this with a drink in your hand, looking down at the fucking floor with not a smile on your face, but not dancing, what the fuck do you expect? It's like walking into a fucking fishmonger's and asking for beef. What are you expecting to get out of it? You'll go into a place which is supposed to be people having fun. Or at least pretending they're having fun. Fuck it. You don't even have to actually be having fun. That's what I fucking realised. I walked into some of these clubs, didn't want to fucking be there. But I was like, right, I can make myself have fun here by trying to fucking have fun and enjoy myself. Go into the middle of the fucking dance floor and stop fucking dancing. I can't dance. Fuck it, no one can fucking dance. Go in there and fucking do it. Into the middle of the dance floor. Grab someone, your mate. Grab a mate, get into the middle of the dance floor and just start fucking dancing. And then maybe you'll start to actually have some fun. Like, you can't have fun by going into a club and being like, I'm just gonna sit on the wall and wait till I start having a good time. And what are you expecting to happen? Are you expecting all the people in the dance floor having fun, dancing with their mates, to suddenly turn around and be like, that guy on the wall, come over here, boy. Let's fucking party. What the fuck are you doing? Has that ever happened to anyone watching this video? No, it hasn't ever happened. No one's gonna be like, that guy in the corner, come on, pal. Let's fucking have a dance. You look like great fun. Fucking hell, bro. You need to put yourself in the environment in the middle of the fucking place and start dancing, and then maybe you'll start enjoying it. Because maybe then you'll start getting other people involved, and maybe they'll start looking at you, oh, he's having a good time. Maybe I'm going to start talking to him now. And then all of a sudden you're talking to people on the fucking dance floor and you're dancing with them. And now you're having fun. But you walked into the club first and you were in a shit mood. But you made it happen for yourself by saying to yourself, I'm in an environment where I'm supposed to be having fun here. So if I don't even try and have fun, this night's going to be a fucking train wreck. I didn't know this back then. So I went into this party not knowing all this shit. And I was that guy standing there awkwardly, not talking to anyone, waiting for someone to say something to me. It never fucking happened, did it? Because no one wanted to speak to me, bro. I was moody. You can't go into a bar club environment and be moody the whole night and expect good results. It's just not something that happens. Like, you know what I'm saying? I could go on for hours about it. But now the second party, the juxtaposition I'm about to talk about is incredible. Second party, university, right? I was already speaking to this girl who was going to the party. We had like this little thing, we were talking, right? She was coming to the party. And I remember having some knowledge of where I was going wrong and what I needed to do. This was 3 years later down the line. So we went into this party. Guys and girls I didn't know. You know, I can't remember specifically what I did. But I just very, very specifically have a clear picture in my mind of the end of the night and how different it was. At the end of the night, all the guys were just... I was standing... I remember, we were about to leave to go to the fucking club. I was standing in the party in the middle of the room. Every single guy was like in a semicircle looking at me. I know it sounds fucking ridiculous, right? It was literally like that. I can remember it. All the guys were fucking looking, wanting to talk to me. I'll be honest, these guys weren't exactly, some of these people weren't exactly the highest value people, right? They weren't exactly the most social confident people, which made it easier for me. I kind of knew stuff back then and I was the kind of more social confident person in that place. Definitely fucking helps. And I was the one like, right, let's fucking go out. We're about to go. I was getting fucking hyped. They were getting hyped because I was getting hyped. Everyone was fucking looking at me. The girl I brought to this party who I was talking to fucking wanted my attention, bro. I'm telling you. Oh my goodness, bro. I can remember it so fucking clearly. At some point during the party, I kind of broke away from everyone and sat down with her, spoke to her on a little chair in the fucking corner of the room. And it was fucking on. She was into me, bro, because she saw what was happening. She saw that I was friends with everyone in this party and everyone wanted to talk to me. That just raised my value. She just wanted to speak to me more before we even went to the fucking club. I could have probably stayed back, but I was like, nah, let's fucking go. I could just remember that there's such a difference between the first one and the second one. I went into these parties trying to become the guy, the sense of attention that everyone wanted to speak to. I was trying to become the social fun guy that was trying to start games. I remember I was trying to start drinking games at this other party. I was the one going, right, let's all play Flip Cup now. And I remember, if you're the one organising it and starting the fucking game and making it exciting for everyone, explaining the rules and demonstrating how to do it, everyone's going to want to fucking speak to you, bro. Oh my goodness. It was incredible. The results I was getting was incredible. And that's what I learned. I learned from these experiences what I was doing right and wrong. And it's just so eye-opening, bro. I could actually go on about this for hours. Yeah, let me know if you like this video and you want more. Let me just put any questions or anything in the comments, yeah? Because I want to fucking engage with you lot. Just put stuff in the comments and I'll reply. Or I'll make a video about it.